PTCI Channel 2 and OPSUAggies.com welcome you to our coverage of Panhandle State Aggies basketball. We are at Anchor D Arena at Oscar Williams Fieldhouse here at Oklahoma Panhandle State University in no man's land. Goodwill, Oklahoma, as the Aggies get ready to take on the number 12th ranked team in the nation, the Langston Lions. Langston comes in with an overall record of 17-5, 9-5 in the Sooner Athletic Conference. The Aggies counter with a 12-8 overall record and 7-7 record in the Sooner Athletic Conference. They're also looking to bounce back from a bad loss, double overtime here at home to Central Christian on Thursday night. They've proven they can beat ranked teams. They've won 3 out of the last 4 against ranked teams. In fact, 2 of those were on the road. So we'll go ahead and give you the starters first for the visitors. A 6'2" junior guard from Newark, New Jersey, number 0, Alfonso Anderson. A 6-foot junior guard from Bridgeport, Connecticut, number 1, Tyrone Killings Jr. A 6'5" senior forward from Mobile, Alabama, number 5, Jerori Coleman. A 6'7" junior forward from Brooklyn, New York, number 20, Knowledge Darby. And a 6'5" sophomore forward from Chicago, Illinois, number 23, David Hunt II. And now the starters for your Aggies. A 5'11", 175-pound senior guard from Harlan, Texas, number 1, Raymond Alexander. A 6'2", 186-pound senior guard from Mesquite, Texas, number 2, Allen Hodge Jr. 5'9", 165-pound junior guard from Des Moines, Iowa, number 3, Khalid Edwards. 6'8", 205-pound junior from Istanbul, Turkey, number 10, Budic Yılker. And at center, a 6'5", 220-pound junior from Boys City, Oklahoma, number 13, Jaden Whitfield. Aggies are coached by head coach Aaron Coombs in his first season. He is assisted by Cole Clearman. The Langston Lions are coached by Stan Holt. He is assisted by Trey Hendon. Both teams get their final instructions from their coaches, and they're getting ready for the opening tip-off.
Christmas list.
Both teams out on the floor. Yılker will jump for the Aggies. Darby will be jumping for the Lions. Remember, the Aggies have been giant killers here of late when it comes to ranked teams. 3 of 4 they've won. 2 on the road against ranked teams in the Sooner Athletic Conference. Budic Yılker all the way to the hoop. Lays it up at him, and the Aggies are on the board in their first possession. Killings with the ball, gives it up at the high post, down low with it, has to go up and underneath, double team, able to beat it as Coleman takes it in for the basket. Alexander over to Hodge. Now Yılker with it. Edwards looked at the 3 for a second. Down low to Whitfield, spins inside and draws a foul. That's going to be on David Hunt II. That'll be his first foul, team's first foul. So Whitfield at the line for 2 shots. He's good at drawing those fouls. Whitfield, very high percentage free throw shooter, misses the first. Whitfield, an 82% free throw shooter.
He'll be below his average on this trip, no matter what happens on the second shot. He does make that one. 3-2, Aggies with the early lead. Coleman back up to Killings. Now over to Anderson behind the back, kicks it outside.
Three.
Shot clock is not running. They finally started it, so they're going to get a long possession this time.
Well, it just went from 28 to 16 on the clock. The middle of a possession.
Shot up and good. Coleman makes the shot, he'll get the and one.
On that possession,
I got a watch though. Shot clock went from 28 to 16 during a possession.
And makes the second. Or makes the shot to convert the three-point play. 5-3 now, Langston with the lead. Edwards with the ball. Look at the screen for him, drives the lane, puts up the shot. It's going to be short as he had to double pump as Darby affected his shot. Ball will be out of bounds to the Aggies. End of Olker, lays it up and in for the easy basket. Beautiful design on the inbound play, makes it 5 each. Killings, he'll give it up to Coleman.
He's holding the roll, man!
Baseline drive and a foul call.
Go ahead.
They'll call that one on Alexander. First foul.
Execute!
Second team foul. Less than 2 minutes into this one, ball kicked outside. Billings gets the screen. He'll back off, take the three, and he drains it. 8-5 now the score. Pass up to Hodge. Pulls up from 15, no good, missed everything there. Darby back the other way with it.
Keep moving it, good.
It's a screen kick outside.
Good extra.
Three-pointer up there by Hunt, and it's good as well. 11-5 now the score. Raymond Alexander with it on the wing. Averaging right about 25 points a game, leading the nation. Ball back outside. Ball into the lane. Shot put up and Whitfield. Good pass into Whitfield, and he's fouled on the shot. And that is going to be on David Hunt. Already his second foul. It's the team's second foul. Already one of their starters in foul trouble. Checking into the game for the first time for Langston, a 6'5" junior forward from Tallahassee, Florida, number 4, Cameron Mack. So Whitfield misses the front end, as we mentioned earlier, 81%, almost 82% from the free throw line. He's missed the front end of both times. He did get the second on each of those. 11-6 now the score. Aggies trail by 5. Three-pointer from the corner. In and out. Whitfield with the rebound. Edwards with it now. Back to Edwards. Raylan Alexander takes the three, no good. Tipped outside by Whitfield, three by Hodge, in and out.
Push, three,
rebounded
three,
by Anderson. Anderson drives inside, banks it off the glass, no good. Rebounded by Alexander in transition. Slows it down for a second. Down low to Whitfield, faces up, turns baseline side, and a jump ball as Mack with some decent defense there for Langston. Team 24 to play.
So quarter.
Here in the first half. Aggies looking to trap. 1-3-1. Three-pointer put up. And it is good by Killings. Langston hitting from hot from deep right now. They've hit three out of four, and it's now a 14-6 lead for the Lions. Pass to Yolker, backs his way into the baseline, kicks outside. Whitfield passes up the three. Lead Edwards drives in, pulls up, short jumper, gets it to go. 14-8 now the score. Foul called on Hodge. That'll be his second already, team's third foul. Drive to the basket, puts it up off the glass, no good. Whitfield with the rebound. Darby missed that one. Yolka with it, now back out top. Railing it. Hitman Alexander misses the open three from the top of the key, out of bounds, back over to Langston. But where Langston's hot from three-point range, the Aggies right now are not. Aggies 0 for 3 so far.
Jerori! Hey, Jerori! Pitch post!
Pull up for three, it is good by Matt. And they are now 4 of 5 from three-point range. Here in the early going, Hodge looks to go baseline. There's the spin, saves it from going out of bounds. Ball will stay with the Aggies.
Hey, just tell me soon, that's all.
Checking into the game, 6'3" senior guard from Duncanville, Texas, number 10, Jeremy Grace. Alexander drives in, shot from the free throw line, no good. The Aggies are just cold right now, missing open shots. Mack with it on the wing, back out top to Killings. All out on the wing. Now at the high post to Coleman, pulls up, misses the shot. Lead Edwards gets the rebound, races ahead, all the way to the hoop, banks it in for the basket. 17-10, we've got a timeout on the court, 14:08 left to play in the first half. Langston leads Panhandle State 17-10.
Don't waste another night waiting on slow internet.
Download files in a flash with 50 meg internet, lightning quick uploads, and no size limit or cap with PTCI. For just $60 a month, you can have incredibly fast, dependable internet. And we'll even throw in 6 months of whole home Wi-Fi for free.
If you're tired of thinking up ways to keep your eyes open while waiting on slow internet, call PTCI today. PTCI.net or 580-338-2556 now.
Hey, Jeremy.
Out of the timeout, Langston with possession, leading by 7.
Let's go, execute, get it across.
Killings will bring the ball up for the Lions.
This way, Joe.
Get a reverse though. Cut, number
12 ranked team in the state. Or in the nation, as I said before, too. Shot missed. Mack with the rebound, the putback, no good. And on the second putback, gets it to go. 19-10. Hodge in the lane. Double clutches, missed the shot. Mack with it, up ahead. Grace puts up the shot. Alley-oop to Mack, lays it up and in. And it is 21-10. With 13 and a half to play, Langston doubling up the Aggies so far. Pass to Yolker, off to the screen. Back outside to Edwards. Takes the deep three, gets it to go. 21-13 now the score. Aggies back in a man defense. Grace drives to the block, puts up the shot off the side of the goal, rebounded by Hodge. Now Alexander with a nice move inside, draws the foul. Couldn't get the shot to go. Foul is going to be on Alfonso Anderson. His first foul, team's third foul. Alexander misses the first one. Checking in for the Aggies for the first time. 5'11", 175-pound sophomore from Norman, Oklahoma. Number 22, Thomas Ellis. Checking in for the Lions. A 6'1" junior guard from Sydney, Australia. Number 22, Keto Brown. Makes the second one, 21-14, the score. And Brown with it, now over to Killings. Still has it at the free throw line, ball to the corner to Brown. Now back up top, into the post to Mack, double team. Kick out through, dumps it down low, spin in the lane, puts it up and in. Basket by Jeremy Grace. 23-14 now the score. Edwards with it on the wing. Had to dump it down low to Yolker, up and underneath. Goes up and draws the foul. Looked like a clean block there by Darby. He's called for the foul. May have got him with the body. Yolker will be going to the line. Yolker's first free throw does fall. Out of four trips to the line, that's the first one they've gotten to fall on the first attempt. And gets the second as well. 23-16 now the score. 12 left to play here in the first half.
Brew! Get a reverse!
Mack, Brown open on the wing. Drives in, puts up the hook, no good. Rebounded though by Darby to give Langston another opportunity. Ball tipped away by Ellis, good defense there. Up ahead to Hodge. Skip pass, Yolker saves that one from going over and back. Edwards with it now. Down low to Yolker, has it knocked away, ball on the floor, Brown. Last to touch it, it'll stay with the Aggies. 14 on the shot clock. Hodge with it up top. Shot clock at 10. Edwards pulls up for three. Can't get that one to go. Mack with the rebound. Killings with it now, leaves it outside for Mack. He'll pull up for three, no good. Rebound though by Grace, and three. Langston is killing the Aggies on the boards. Darby with it, cross pass. Brown inside, lays it up and in. 25-16 now, the score with 11 left to play in the first half. Edwards with the ball. The high post to Yolker. Let's the defender go by, lays it up and in, 25-18. Mack with it. Now back up top to Killings. Baseline jumper, no good. Edwards with the rebound, back the other way. Outside to Hodge, he'll pull up for three, and he gets it to go. Three-pointer by Hodge makes it a four-point game, 25-21. We have reached the midway point of the first half.
Get away, Tito!
Grace drives in, no good on the shot. Outside as he tipped it back out to Killings Jr. around the perimeter. Mack with it now. Pulls up from 15, no good. Rebound by Hodge. Hodge with it outside, pulls up for three, and he gets a second one to go. We've got a timeout on the court. The Aggies are back within one with 9:32 left in the first half. It's Langston 25, Panhandle 24.
Okay, Josh, do your stuff.
Okay, people, you know the drill. Canned foods only, guys. Sometimes you gotta live what you believe, open your arms, cause that's where it starts. Right here with you and with me, I know. Well, it's not enough. Generosity, pass it on. A little from up above, fit to me. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Langston with possession out of the timeout. Aggies have cut it to a one-point game. Drive baseline, kicks it over to Mack, goes up, blocked by Whitfield, but lays it up and in. 27-24.
Pull up, pass, go to the ball. Heels up.
Edwards with the ball. Over to Yolker. Knocked it away. As Young got his hand on that one. Number 13, Malik Young, a 6'1" senior guard from Flint, Michigan. Hodge will bring it across the timeline again. Shot clock down to 7. Pulls off. Can't get that three to go, as that was a bit of a desperation shot just to beat the shot clock. Mack with it back the other way. Coleman with it now on the wing, guarded by Yolker. Back up top, Mack for three from the top of the key, and he drains it. 30-24 now the score. Alexander drives in the lane, puts it up, and gets the foul call. Foul will be on Keto Brown, his first, team's fifth foul. So Brayman Alexander at the line, one of the top free throw shooters in the nation, shooting 85%, makes the first. 8:17 left to play in the first half. And gets the second one as well. 30-26. Now the score.
Hey, 41 rep. Let's go.
Here we go.
Three-pointer put up by Coleman. No good. Ball loose. Young gets the rebound. Goes baseline. Pulls back out for three. No good. Rebounded by Alexander. pulls up near the free throw line, well short of it. Ball out of bounds, last touch by Langston. Referees discussing whether the ball actually hit the rim. They did. So they'll move the shot clock to 21. Ball into Whitfield, hands it off to Edwards. And an offensive foul. Going to be called on Whitfield. Yep. That will be Whitfield's first, team's fourth foul.
Drury, up, Drury. Keto, corner, up, Drury, up.
So Young kicks it outside. Shot put up, rebounded by Edwards. Race up quickly, Hodge in the corner with it. Drives in the lane, fall away shot, in and out. Whitfield tries to go for the rebound, and he is fouled by Brown. Good effort there by Whitfield. Brown call for his second team's sixth foul. All out top. Now Whitfield with it. Gives it back to Yonker. Spins baseline. Kicks it outside. Too wide for Alexander. Ball turned over to Langston. Anderson checks back in for the Lions. 7:05 left to play here in the first half. 4-point game. Grace with it on the wing. Hits it to the cutter, Coleman through the lane. Drives in, baseline turnaround jumper, no good. Whitfield with the rebound. He spiked it off the ground. Yoker saves it from going out of bounds, up to Hodge. Back out, gives it to Alexander. Back to Hodge, drives inside, puts up the jumper, gets it to go, and he draws the foul. You could hear the slap over here on that one.
Foul is going to be called on number 10, Grace.
That'll be Grace's first foul.
Frank, you got the same opportunity. Let's see what
you checking in for the Lions, a 6'1" sophomore guard from Chicago, Illinois, number 25, Greg McDowell. So Hodge at the line trying to convert the 3-point play. And he does. It's a 1-point game, 30-29, just under 6.5 left to play in the first half. Ball on the wing to Coleman. Tries to go inside, backs out. Give it up to McDowell. Ball left for Young, drives in, gets the floater to go. 32-29. Edwards with the ball out top, gives it up to Alexander. Gets it to Whitfield, puts it up and in. 1-point game again, 32-31. Beautiful pass there by Alexander to the open man. Whitfield did a great job with the defender right on him, getting that one up and in. Baseline drive by Anderson, puts up the shot, in and out, rebounded by Whitfield. Edwards up to Hodge. Hodge behind the back in the lane, puts up the floater. Aggies take the lead, 33-32. 5:15 left in the first half. They'll leave it up top for Young, guarded tightly there by Edwards. Anderson now on the wing. All around the perimeter to Coleman. He'll pull back for three, in and out. Ball tipped all the way out to midcourt.
Get back.
And they save it from going over the midcourt stripe. Reset the shot clock. But Coleman with possession of it up top. Mac looked at the three. As they try to post up Edwards. Dow with it. And a charge call. Great defense there by Khalid Edwards to draw the charge. That's going to be foul number one on McDowell, eighth team foul. So Edwards will bring it up for the Aggies. Gets it over to Hodge, knocked away for a second, able to get it back. Inside, brings it across, can't get it up. Mack with the rebound. As Anderson saved that one from going out of bounds. Coleman past the corner. Too high for Young. Ball turned back over to the Aggies. Edwards drives all the way to the hoop. Show! Shot, you can hear it here, partially blocked, but he got it up and in anyway. 35-32. Coach Coombs wanting a foul there on that one. As you could hear the slap over here. Edwards hounding Coleman, ball to the corner. Mack for three, no good. Whitfield with the strong rebound. Ball up to Hodge. Hodge spinning the lane, kicks it to the corner to Yolkert. He'll step in to the lane, puts up the floater. It's good, 37-32. So after a slow start, the Aggies fighting back. Young with it, guarded there by Edwards. He'll pull up for three, no good. Rebound by Whitfield. As he gets back into shape, he's showing the same traits he showed last year when he led the nation in rebounding. Hodge picks up his dribble, gets it to Yolker. He'll drive in the lane, kicks the corner. Whitfield, no good on the three, rebounded by Mack. Ball into the corner, spin by Coleman. Has to kick it out, nobody there. But Anderson able to chase it down. He'll put up the three. No good. And Alexander with the rebound on the backside. We've got a timeout on the court. 2:25 left in the first half. And Edo State leads Langston 37-32. possession of a 5-point lead. They'll have it.
All right, Aggie Hanson, let's
so far in this quarter, the first half. Allen Hodge Jr. already with 11. He's 4 of 10 from the field, 2 of 4 from the three-point line. Aggie's shooting 48% from the field, 33 from 3, and 72 from the free throw line. And Edwards going to be called for the double dribble there. This is the entire Langston bench there to inform the ref of that one.
Three times left.
Buttich Alker also with in double figures with 10. He's 4 of 4 from the field and 2 of 2 at the free throw line. Kick across, pass across the lane, off the hands of Darby by Killings. And out of bounds back over to the Aggies. Aggies, as we mentioned earlier, very slow start, fell behind earlier. Langston was hot behind the three-point line. The Aggies have turned it around big time. Ball in to Whitfield. Couldn't grab a hold of it. Turnover back to the Lions. Darby with it. Looks to go baseline on Olker. Good positioning defensively. Back outside to Coleman. Anderson with it. He'll drive in. Dumps it across the lane. Puts it up and in. For Darby, and he draws a foul. That's going to be on Whitfield. He'll be his second already. Oh, Joker with the rebound. Edwards with it outside, gets it over to Hodge at the free throw line. He'll pull back out. 12 on the shot clock. He'll try to isolate. Ball tipped away though. Anderson takes it up to the dunk. It's a 1-point lead for the Aggies. Under a minute left in this half. Edwards with it now. It's going to be a reach foul on Anderson. Ellis checks back in for the Aggies. So Edwards at the line as that is the ninth team foul. Edwards sinks the first in his first trip to the line. 47.8 left to play here in the half. And makes the second as well. 39-36. Aggies with the lead. Killings gets it over to Coleman. Back over to Killings, spins, kick to the corner, three-pointer up by McDowell, no good. Whitfield tips it out to Edwards. In transition, oh, beautiful move to the hole and lays it up and in. What a move by Edwards. 41-36, 15 to play. They'll hold it out top for the final shot. Killings Jr. gives it up to Coleman. 6 on the clock, pulls up for 3, dumps it down low to Anderson. Ball knocked away by Anderson, but the foul is going to be called on Anderson. His second, team's 6th foul. Look, Khalid Edwards. We all remember Coach Coombs talking about what a special player we're going to have with Khalid Edwards when he came in this second semester. And that was the kind of moves he was talking about. Anderson sinks the first. Three 3.3 left to play. Second shot from Anderson. Gets them both. 41-38. Inbounded to Edwards. Half court shot. Too strong. So we head to the half after a slow start for the Aggies. Panhandle State leads at the halftime. 41-38 over the number 12 ranked Langston Lions. We'll be back with the second half. Getting ready for the second half of play here. Aggies leading by three. Aggies were 14-29 from 48% in the first half in the field. 3 of 10 from 3-point range for 30%, and 10 of 13 from the line for 76.9%. Langston countered, going 14 of 37 from the field for 37.8%. And 5 of 16 from 3-point range for 31.3, and that was after starting out making 4 of their first 5. They're also 3 of 4 at the free throw line. For the Aggies, they've got 3 players in double digits. Khalid Edwards leads the way, 5 of 8 from the field, 1 of 3 from 2, and 2 for 2 at the free throw line for 13 points. Allen Hodge Jr. is 4 of 10 from the field, 2 of 4 from 3, 1 of 1 at the line for 11. And Budich Olker, 4 of 4 from the field, 2 of 2 at the line for 10 points. Aggies with just 4 turnovers in the first half, Langston with 3. Their only player in double digits, Cameron Mack, came off the bench. He's gone 5 of 9 from the field, 2 of 4 from 3-point range for 12 points. He's also their leading rebounder with 9. Jaden Whitfield leads the Aggies with 6. The Aggies again trying to knock off another ranked opponent. As I mentioned earlier, they've beat 3 of the last 4 ranked teams they've played. Teams getting final instructions from their coaches. They'll get ready to start this second half. Panhandle State will have possession of the ball to start this half, leading by 3. Edwards with the ball, on top, he'll get the screen off of Whitfield, backs it back out, loses control, get it back, baseline drive, kicks to the corner, that'll be Hodge outside to Alexander, fadeaway shot, baseline, too short, Aggies did not get a good offensive possession there, Langston with some high quality defense to start this second half. Anderson with the ball. Ball around the perimeter. Pass inside, good look. And Killings Jr. lays it up and in. It's a 1-point game, 41-40. Whitfield with it at the high post. Gives it up to Yolker, now back to Edwards. Hodge pulls up for 3 from the wing, no good. Rebounded by Darby, back the other way for the Lions. Hunt with it, up top. Coleman now back over to Anderson. He'll pull up from the top of the key and he drains it. Langston retakes the lead, 43-41. Alexander with it, guarded there by Anderson. Pass to the high post to Whitfield. Hand off to Edwards. Pulls up for three, and he drains it. 44-43. Aggies retake the lead. Anderson with it on the wing. Back up top to Hunt. Coleman dumps it down low. Edwards guarding. Back outside, three from the top of the key by Hunt. No good. Rebound by Anderson. Loses control of the ball. Back over to the Aggies.
Come on, guard, guard!
Yelker gives it back to Edwards. Now over to Alexander for three. And he drains it. 47-43. Aggies lead by four. Baseline give and go back to Coleman. Nice, nice give and go there. Makes it 47-45.
By yourself! By yourself! By yourself!
Hodge with the ball. Alexander from the corner for three. No good. Can't get that one to rattle home. Rebounded by Darby back the other way. Dives, kicks outside.
Plenty of time.
Coleman with it out top. Coleman pulls up, fade away. Rebound there by Darby. Just too many offensive rebounds. That makes about eight or nine for Langston here. Foul is going to be called on Hodge Jr. That will be his third, team's first foul of the second half. First free throw off the back iron, no good. And David Hunt, the second. Misses the second. Rebounded and put back up by Anderson. Missed the shot though. Anderson gets the loose ball again and lays it up and in. Tie ball game at 47 apiece. Just over 16 and a half left to play. Alexander. Edwards drives in the lane and is fouled. Killings call for the foul. That'll be his first, team's first foul of the half.
TJ, hold. Watch the back screen. There you go.
Yelker for three from the corner. No good. Rebounded by Anderson. Pass up ahead, underneath, lays it up and in. Darby puts it in and draws the foul on Yelker. Aggie defense gets back late, and the Lions take advantage of it. They retake the lead. And can't convert the three-point play, though, but another offensive rebound, this time by Hunt. Three-pointer, no good. Coleman with the rebound. Out of bounds, off his knee, and over to Panhandle State. Coach Stan Holt for the Lions going ballistic, wanting a foul call.
Now it's sink.
Edwards gives it up to Alexander. Now Edwards over to Yelker.
Good job, TJ. Keep cutting.
Hands it off to Edwards. Back outside to Hodge. Hodge kicks to the corner. Alexander for three. He drains it. Aggies retake the lead. We've got a timeout on the floor. 15:47 to play. It's Panhandle State 50, Langston 49. trailing by one out of the timeout. Coleman with it, gives it up to Killings. Back to Coleman. He spins near the lane. Elbows his way in for a shot. 31, 51, 50. Ellis pulls up for three, and he drains it. 53-51. Now back out top to Killings. Skip pass to the opposite corner. Anderson for three, no good. Anderson with the rebound. Now Coleman with it on the wing, back up top to Killings. Killings with the drive on Olker, puts it up, no good. Ellis called for the foul as Whitfield comes back in. He'll come in for Olker. Up and underneath. Unbelievable basket there by Coleman. Just incredible athletics. 53 all. Edwards dumps it down low to Whitfield, knocked away from behind, gets it back though. Hodge pulls up for three, he's fouled. No call on the foul. Laid up and in by Ellis, 55-53. Up ahead into the corner, Darby. Dumps it down low. Hodge steals it on the inbound play. Pushes ahead. All the way to the hoop. Off the front of the rim. No good. Anderson with the rebound back the other way. Coleman all the way to the hoop. Misses the shot but draws a foul. Edwards called for the foul. His first, team's fourth foul.
I'm done with him. Get him up from the stands, please.
Thank you.
We can have all of you guys down by the door. The referee says you've got to move to the stands, please.
Hey, why? Jeremiah! Why?
Guys, down by the door, please move to the stands.
Well, they're telling the players that are standing along the side to move.
He wants to know why. They're talking.
During the girls' game, we had Langston players standing along the sideline talking, but no referee made them leave, but they're going to make the Panhandle players leave. So Coleman at the line shooting.
Get him one then.
Right here. Right here. Stop. No, sir. No. Over there.
Hey.
Now the referee's telling the fans where they can sit. Good by Coleman. And they're not going to let the players be there. They're making the players move. That is absolutely ridiculous. If a player can't handle talking, then he probably shouldn't be out there. Free throw is good by Coleman as he makes them both. 55 all, 13:43 still to play. Raylan Alexander with it, gives it up to Edwards. His legs, free throw line, pulls up, can't get the shot to go. Over the back call is going to be on Darby. As he hits him in the back of the head, He'll call the foul.
His
second, team's second as well. Whitfield with the ball.
Take it!
Shot blocked by Mack. Back the other way, Coleman with it. And Hodge ties it up. Alexander ties it up, but a foul call there. Killings inbounds the ball. Darby trying to get it to Darby. Ball out of bounds. Last touch by Darby. Good job by Edwards. And a technical foul called. Now on Darby for Langston. Things have escalated here quite a bit. So Khalil Edwards will take the technicals. Still not understanding why they would move fans to other areas. Makes the second one. So Aggies retake the lead 56-55.
McDowell checks in for the Lions.
Aggies ball.
Coach, you said next time out. Coach, you said next time out. Hey, go, go.
Edwards brings it up. Ellis takes it at the top of the key. Now to Whitfield. Hand off to Alexander. Pulls up for three. No good. Ball tipped around. Ellis gets the rebound. Kicks it outside to Hodge. Drives in the lane, kicks it out. Ellis for three. He's got two of them now. 59-55, they take the lead. Extend it to four. Killings with the ball out top. And Dow back to Coleman. Drives the line of the paint and draws a foul.
Foul's going to be coming on number 22, TC Ellis. That is the second personal foul. 16 foul on Aggies.
So Coleman back at the line shooting. Coleman makes the first. It's 12:31 left to play. Makes them both. Buttich Olker checks back into the game as Ellis will go back to the bench. Hodge brings it up. Down to Whitfield. Lays it up and in. 61-57. Coleman with it now. Back outside, Anderson. He walked with it, no call. Puts up the short jumper, gets his own rebound, kicks it outside. Back off the foot of Hodge. We've got a timeout on the floor. 11:59 to play. It's Panhandle State 61, Langston 57.
All aboard! Next stop, PTCI for new smartphones. Get on the PTCI cellular train for huge savings.
This season, get a Christmas gift of $600 off the regular price of any new smartphone at PTCI with a new activation. Are you caught up in a long-term contract with the other guys? No worries, PTCI will help you out. Come see us now.
Check us out at ptci.net or call 580-338-2556.
Nothing ever gonna make this world better if we don't start believing.
That love really, really, really is the answer. Everybody join hands, cause it's time now.
Timeout. Aggies leading by four. Kind of an amazing stat for a team that's ahead. Aggies being out rebounded on the offensive end 15-3. Aggies only have 16 defensive rebounds, so they're almost being out rebounded at that end of the floor. Drive kick outside by Anderson, loses control, gets it back. Coleman with it now. Ball loses control of it. Back the other way, Aggies ball. Edwards brings it up. Gives it off to Yoker. Down low to Whitfield, turns baseline side, missed the shot. Mack with the rebound, now in transition, up ahead to Coleman. Dumps it across to Mack, lays it up and in. 61-59 now the score. Edwards drives underneath, kicks it out to Alexander, over to Hodge. Hodge drives, baseline shot, in and out. Can't get it to go. Mack in transition now, pulls up inside the paint, ties it up at 61 apiece.
Hey, my fault about what I said earlier. I apologize. Defense!
Alexander drives. And he's fouled. They'll say on the floor. That's going to be on Mack. That will be his first.
Stop!
So coming into the game, Brown. And another technical foul on Langston. Alexander at the line, shooting the technicals. Sinks that one. Aggies lead 62-61. The 63-61. Alexander for three, no good. Mack with the rebound. Coleman pulls up and drains the three. Edwards with it now. Aggies trail by one. Edwards pulls up at the free throw line, no good. Long rebound, loose ball. Langston comes away with it.
Push, push, push.
Mack with it, steps inside, gets it to go. 66-62. Hodge out top with it. Yoker pass to Whitfield at the high post, hands off to Hodge, drives to the block, can't get it to go. Rebounded by Brown. Back the other way, Anderson with it. Loses control of it, met Mack there. Oh, what a block by Whitfield! Beautiful block! Alexander with it, and the foul called on Coleman. It's a fantastic block by Jaden Whitfield.
Five,
No, it's right now. Yeah, they had 63, and they corrected it. I don't even know what's been going on.
They have corrected the scoreboard. Referee discussing with the scores table to make sure everything's right. Into Olker, gets it to go. 66-64. Now the score, Langston with a 2-point lead. Inside to Anderson, shot blocked by Whitfield. Discussing whether both of those field goals were made. Put up by Coleman, missed. Whitfield with the rebound. Hodge with it outside. Hands it off to Alexander. He'll pull it out to midcourt. 12 on the shot clock. The give and go to Olker. Up underneath, waits for the defender. Back to the right side. Beautiful play. We're tied up at 66 apiece. Coombs upset is that technical foul. Nobody quite sure if he made the first one or not. I believe he made both. Aggies would lead by one. Into the paint to Mack. Guarded there by Olker. Double team outside. Anderson pulls up for three. And he drains it. 69-66. Edwards to Whitfield, faces up.
Yeah!
And an offensive foul. That's going to be on Whitfield. Darby and Grace check into the game for Langston. Langston with possession, leading by three. Just under 8 minutes left in this one. Aggies trying to upset another ranked opponent. Baseline drive by Mack, lays it up and in. 71-66 now the score. Alexander drives, lays it up, and he's fouled. He'll go to line for two shots. Good screen there by Whitfield. Brown call for the foul. That's his third, team's seventh foul. Both teams in the bonus the rest of the way. One free throw by Alexander is good. 7:37 left to play. And gets the second one as well, 68-71. I do have video confirmation from our filmer that definitely Panhandle State made both of those. Three-pointer from the corner by Matt, 74-68 now. Edwards with it, pass down low to Whitfield, lays it up and in, 74-70. Brown, now over to Grace. He'll get a screen for Mack, give and go. And lays it up and in, and a foul call on Edwards on that one. That's his second, team's eighth foul. Whitfield checks out as Ellis comes back in. 6:47 left to play. Still cannot believe they won't let fans sit behind the Langston bench. Apparently these guys can't handle talking. Mack makes the free throw. 77-70 now the score. Edwards drives all the way to the hoop. Hit off of Coleman's back. The Aggies will maintain possession.
Coach, we haven't guarded this play well at all.
Hey, sit in, Cap! Wow, okay.
Ball into Yolker.
Good job, Jeremy.
Goes baseline.
Good job, Jeremy. Cut off. Good job, Jeremy.
Out to Alexander near midcourt. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Pulls up, and he drains it! 72-77. Brown kicks it out to Coleman. Coleman drives in, kicks out to the corner. Grace puts up the three, it's short. But Mack there for the putback. We've got a timeout on the court, 5:54 left to play. It's Langston 79, Panhandle State 72.
Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood.
Out of the timeout, Aggies with possession of the ball, trailing by seven. Hodge with the ball. Back over to Edwards. Aggies at times having trouble against this man-to-man defense. Down low to Whitfield, turns inside. Puts it up off the glass, no good. Ball tipped up again and again. Mack comes away with the rebound.
Get it up, get it up, get it up. Get it up, get it up.
Mack with the ball. Coleman now with it. And a foul call. Shot missed. That'll be on Hodge. That'll be his fourth. Team's ninth. Coleman sinks the first. And makes them both. 81-72 now the score. Aggies in need with an offensive boost here. 5 minutes left to play. Hodge back to Edwards. Ball loose out front. Alexander picks it up. 10 on the shot clock. Whitfield gets the screen. Alexander pulls up for three off the rim. No good. Long rebound by Grace. Brooke inside. Now out to Coleman. Pulls up for three and he drains it. 84-72 now the score. Up to Hodge. Hodge drives in, and a blocking foul is called. Hodge goes to the ground. That's on Darby. That'll be number four on him, eighth team foul. Allen Hodge at the line. Allen Hodge makes the first one. Makes them both 84-74. So Coleman with the ball out front. Aggies looking to trap them in this 1-3-1 zone. Darby with it, looks to go baseline, kicks it to the corner, and out of bounds, ball back to Panhandle State. 3:52 left to play. Aggies down by 10. Push up ahead to Hodge. Drives all the way to the block, up and under. Outside to Alexander for three. Can't get it to go. Whitfield fights for the rebound, puts it up. No call. Somehow no call. Edwards comes away with the loose ball. And there's a foul. Now there was no foul on that shot. That'll be four on Brooks. Or Brooke. Actually, Brown is his name. Sorry about that.
Are you describing the hostility well?
I tell you what, when they come to Langston, you better not have any hostility. That's on court advantage.
84-74 the score. Langston with the lead. Brown with it over to Coleman. Three-pointer from the corner is good by Grace. And a foul call. That will be on Grace. So Edwards back at the line. That'll be two on Grace. Yeah. Free throw by Alexander is good. Anderson comes in. So Darby checks out of the game. 3:04 to play, 87-75. Alexander misses the second. Rebounded by Grace. Holman all the way to the hoop, misses the shot. Alexander with the long rebound. Races ahead, two defenders. Draws the foul, gets the shot to go. He'll go to the line for the and one. And that will be number five on Brown. Alexander at the line, trying to make it a single-digit game. He does, 87-78. Full court pressure by the Aggies, 2:44 to play. Ball inbounded to Killings. They'll pass it across over to Grace. Now back to Killings as they come across the midcourt stripe. Now they'll pull out to midcourt, trying to use as much time as they can. Gives it off to Coleman. Coleman dishes it outside to Grace, drives in the lane all the way to the hoop, lays it up and in. 89-78 now the score. 2:15 to play. Nice, beautiful pass by Hodge to Holker, who was underneath the basket, 89-80. 2 minutes still left to play. Mack with it outside. He'll give it up to Coleman. All over to Killings. Shot clock at 10. Kicks it over to Anderson. Misses the shot. Whitfield with the rebound. Dumps it outside to Edwards. Up to Hodge. Spins baseline, kicks it out. Nobody there. Killings there for the loose ball. Went too deep, really. And Alexander going to be called for the foul on the steal attempt. That's going to be number four on him. Free throw is good by Killings Jr.
Hey, Cam, who are you guarding?
1:27 left to play, makes the second, and it's 11-point game again.
Who's got 10? Who's got 10?
Edwards brings it up. Drives inside, takes it all the way to the hoop, missed. Whitfield with the putback. Timeout on the court, 1:17 to play. It's Langston 91, Panhandle State 82.
Don't waste another night waiting on slow internet.
Download files in a flash with 50 meg internet, lightning quick uploads, and no size limit or cap with PTCI. For just $60 a month, you can have incredibly fast, dependable internet. And we'll even throw in 6 months of whole home Wi-Fi for free.
If you're tired of thinking up ways to keep your eyes open while waiting on slow internet, call PTCI today. PTCI.net or 580-338-2556 now.
Okay, Josh, do your stuff.
Okay, people, you know the drill. Canned foods only, guys. Living off your seat. Sometimes you gotta live what you believe. Open your arms, cause that's where it starts. Right here with you and with me. I know, well, this love is love. Generosity, pass it on. A little hope from up above. Fear to me. A
a message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Out of the timeout, Langston with possession of the ball, leading by nine. Trying to force a turnover here, and a foul is going to be called on Ellis. So they'll walk to the other end, and it will be Grace shooting free throws.
We're going to call on TC Ellis.
Grace sinks the first free throw.
You gotta be up there though.
Whitfield checks back in.
I just don't want to miss it.
1:12 left to play. Misses it. Ulker with the rebound. He's immediately fouled. So they'll walk to the other end, and Ulker will be shooting free throws.
That's going to become number 10, Grace. That'll be his third.
Ulker at the line for two shots, as this is the double bonus. Both teams in it the rest of the way. Ulker makes the first. Ellis checks in for defense. And gets the second on himself. That'll make 18 points for him. 92-84 now the score. Anderson with it, breaks through, dumps it over to Mack, lays it up and in. 84-94 with 1 minute left to play. Alexander with it, drives in. Can't get it to roll in, and immediately a foul. They'll call that on Ulker, and Coleman will shoot free throws. Coleman's first free throw off the front of the rim. Also, Darby back in for Langston, makes the second free throw. 95-84, 52 seconds left to play. Edwards puts up the floater, can't get it to go. Anderson with the rebound, and he's immediately fouled. That's going to be on Whitfield. Anderson makes the first.
Thank you.
35 seconds left, 97-84. Alexander, deep three, drains it. We've got a timeout on the court, 40 seconds left, 97-87. Langston with the lead. Shooting 60% here in the second half of the field. Also 6 of 10 from three-point range even here in the second half. Just an incredible shooting half for the Lions. Ball in batted to Coleman, immediately fouled. Hodge Jr. called for his fifth, actually, so he'll check out of the game. First free throw, no good. Gets the second though, 98-87. Edwards with it. Brings it up. Whitfield drives in, kicks out. Edwards saves that one. Back outside at Yolker for three. Can't get it to go. Whitfield with the rebound, misses the putback. Darby comes away with the rebound. So Darby at the line for two shots. Makes the first, 21.3 left to play. With the rebound off the miss. Passes up ahead to Ellis. Shoots at the free throw line. It's good. 99-89 the score with 12.4 left to play. Leading by 10. Here with 12.4 left to play. All inbounded to Anderson. Brings it across midcourt. Dumps it outside to Mack. And they'll run up the final few seconds. Langston has defeated Panhandle State 99-89. Stick around, we'll talk to head coach Aaron Coombs in just a moment.
tough, hard-fought game. Just your thought on the game and thoughts on the game and team's play tonight.
Hey, credit Langston. You know, we got out tough, man. I mean, it's 16 offensive rebounds. The number one key in the game was the blockout. You know, so it is what it is. I mean, we are not going to win games giving up 16 offensive rebounds. We got out tough. They played harder. You know, we did some good things offensively, but, yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, the whole game plan was to protect the paint and block out, and we didn't either. For them to score 61 points, and we gave them probably 10 points in free throws, so for them to score 51 points in the second half, I mean, we didn't play good enough D to win, so, I mean, we didn't deserve to win this game. Credit to Langston, you know, but, you know, first half, we were one team, second half, we were another. In the second half, they were the aggressor, and that's why they won.
Well, it didn't hurt them that they shot the ball very well in that second half, not only inside, but outside as well. I think they were 6 of 10 from three-point range even in that second half. So they didn't hurt themselves with their offensive output either.
Well, look, threes are not going to beat us against Langston. They're just not. You know, so at halftime they had 4 free throws. They finished with 26. That's going to beat you. At halftime they had 6 offensive rebounds. They had 16. That's going to beat you. It's not the threes. I mean, the threes are not – I mean, 33 points out of their 99 came from three. I mean, that's, you know, so it's that's not what's going to beat us. And that's what we told our guys all day. And, you know, we kept getting spread out. They scored in transition, layup, offensive rebound, and so we lose.
Well, and, of course, I know you'll be preaching the same thing to your team. As your daughter tries to get your attention here, I know you'll continue to be preaching the same thing because I know going forward that's what it's going to be. Figure out the rebounding issue, right?
No question. You know, I mean, you know, like our Buttis can't play 37 minutes and have 4 rebounds. Can't do it. You know, Alan Hodge can't play 40 minutes and have 3 rebounds. It just, you know, so, I mean, it's got to be a team effort. It's got to be a collective effort. And, I mean, you know, it's if we rebound, we're going to win most games, in my mind. If we don't rebound, we're not. You know, at halftime, the rebound margin was they were up plus 1. They finished plus 16. That's why you lose.
Well, Coach, a little off of the game, just a little bit, just the surroundings about it. I don't know. I've seen referees tell people to get off of a court or something like that. I don't know that I've ever seen them assign their seating. When you go to Langston next time, do you think you're going to at least ask, say, hey, we don't need anybody from the other team sitting behind us?
I mean, you know, it is what it is. I'm so proud of our football team, man. They were awesome. You know, we can't get caught up in that. That's not our job during the game. But no, to answer your question, we go to Langston, it's worse. You know, I mean, so, but that's part of a home court advantage. That's part of what makes the game fun. You know, it's a crowd environment, and we've got it to where our crowd is involved, and so I mean, it's great. It helps us, but at the end of the day, we got to be tough enough to not worry about outside things and focus on what we preach and practice and rebound. So,
well, a tough weekend for the Aggies as they go 0-2 over this one. You guys will look to bounce back next week on the road.
Yep, 2 road games. I mean, at Bay Cone, and I think at John Brown. I mean, tough road games. We got to regroup, and we need to go get 2 wins. It's 2 teams we've beat. It's going to be hard to beat them at their place. I mean, regardless of, I don't care that Bay Cone hasn't won a game. They're still tough.
Yeah.
You know, and John Brown, they're second team in the league. So it won't be easy, but we have to regroup, and we got to figure some things out personnel-wise. We got to figure some things out, you know, schematically from a coaching standpoint. And if we do that, we'll be fine.
Well, I think the interview's over because they're turning off the lights.
Yeah, they're rushing us out of here. So, yeah.
So, good day from no man's land. And make sure to check in next time. The Aggies are at home. Come out and see them. Great action. Even if they don't win, it seems like there's great drama at every game. So, good day from Goodwell, Oklahoma.
Thanks, man.